Hey everyone, this is Tim from Your Six Studios. Today in this video, I'm going to go ahead and show you how to fix the orange or yellow blinking light on your PlayStation 5 controller. So let's go ahead and jump in the video right now. So is your controller not working? It's simply not charging or it's not connecting to the PlayStation 5? Well, I'm going to go and show you some tips to go ahead and fix that. Now, the first thing we want to go ahead and do is completely turn off our PlayStation 5. So let's hold down the power button right here, and you'll hear one beep initially, and then you'll hear another beep about 5 seconds later, and then your PlayStation 5 will go ahead and begin to shut off. And what we're going to do is hard reset our console. So turn it around now and unplug it from the wall outlet. So let's go ahead and do that right now and unplug it. Then leave it unplugged for about 1 to 2 minutes and then plug it back in. Now, on your PlayStation 5 controller, if it's not already turned off, go ahead and hold down the PlayStation button right here for about 5 to 10 seconds, and you'll notice the light bar will turn off now and your controller will be completely turned off. Then if you flip the controller around, I have a modded aim controller right here and I have back buttons. But located right here is a small hole. Go ahead and reset your controller by using a toothpick or maybe a small pin and just press it in there and hold it down, and this will reset the controller. Now that our controller is reset and turned off, let's take a USB cable and plug it into the front of the PlayStation 5, just like this. Now when the light is orange, that's indicating that your controller is charging. Sometimes I can have my controller plugged in just like this and it's orange and is charging, but it won't connect to the console. And sometimes I have to repeatedly press the PlayStation button in. So I can press it down once and it'll turn on, but sometimes I have to repeatedly press this button for it to actually turn on the console. So there could be a problem with the PlayStation button and the conductive film if you ever want to open up the controller. Maybe just spray it out with some compressed air in case there's some sort of issue with the conductive film. So now that our controller is connected to the console, there may be an issue with the Bluetooth. So we're going to go ahead and go into the settings, forget this controller, and then repair it back to the console. So we're going to need a second controller or use your phone. There's the PlayStation Remote Play application. You can download from the Apple Store or the Android Store, and this will allow you to take full control of your PlayStation using your smartphone. So it's called PlayStation Remote Play. Go ahead and try it out if you do not have another controller. All right, so I'm logging in with my second controller now, and I'm gonna go up to settings and select this option, and then go on down until I see accessories and select this option, then go over to general Bluetooth accessories and select this option, and then you're going to see a couple controllers in here. So this controller is the controller that's technically not working, so I'm going to go to it and select it with X, and then I'm going to go to delete and press OK, and this will be forgotten, and press OK. Now another thing I want to make note of is, let's say your controller is connected to your smartphone via Bluetooth, or is connected to like an iPad or something, or maybe a different console. What you'd want to go ahead and do is forget the device on your phone or the other Bluetooth device. So do you want to go to Bluetooth under here, go to your controller and forget it. So let's go to wireless controller real quick and just go to on pair. Boom, that controller is now off of my phone. So now the controller's off my list on the PlayStation 5. Let's press the PlayStation button and the share button together at the same time. And this will put the controller into the sync mode. All right, let's go ahead and do it again and hold it down. All right, now it's flashing and it should show up under this list. So here it is. So let's go to this with our working controller, press X on it, and go to yes, do you want to register this device? Now this controller should be working, and I have to log in with an account now. And I am now connected. So here we go. My controller is working. I'm logging into my account. Now, if it doesn't connect right away, try that USB cable again. And if it doesn't work in the front USB port, try the back USB ports. Maybe that is causing an issue. But this will be the quickest way to resync, reconnect your controller back to your PlayStation. Also, if you are having a charging problem with your PlayStation 5 controller, if it's not charging from the front USB port, try the rear USB port. Otherwise, try a power adapter just like this for the wall outlet and plug it directly into the wall outlet for approximately 1 to 2 hours, just until it's fully charged. So hopefully this video did indeed help you out. If it did, leave it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below for more tech help videos coming up next on Your Six Studios.